The European Central Bank releases their proposal for Eurotarp. And did you know that the FBI actually puts people on their terrorist watch list who have already been cleared of crimes?
Oh yeah.
Hey guys, it's September 28th, 2011. My name is Reginald, and I'm also known as DemCad. First, Eurotarp. Okay, the European Central Bank is going to create a special purpose vehicle, a special fund where they're going to put some money into it. They're going to try to get investors to buy up some bonds, and they're going to use this as collateral to help other European countries that are in debt. The problem is they're insolvent. They're insolvent, and all they're doing is just moving funds around in the hopes of trying to save themselves some time. You have insolvent countries, and you have the more solvent countries. The better countries have a whole lot of money in the insolvent countries. So when the insolvent countries collapse, they're going to bring down the other countries as well. So that's the situation you have in Europe. There's a viral video of this financial trader talking about this is going to be a big opportunity for him. The next depression is going to be a big opportunity for him. The market is going to completely collapse, and there's nothing we could pretty much do to stop this whole collapse. And he referenced the first Great Depression as a situation where a lot of people lost money, but some people actually made money off of all actual collapse. I thought it was a pretty interesting video. He was supposedly on BBC. I don't know what was the source of it. I don't care, but the information is just spot on. And I'm glad to see this actually get some exposure. Speaking of some serious problems or being spot on, speaking of depression, I should say, home sales were actually down 2.3%. They're at 50-year lows at this point. They haven't been this low in decades. I think they're on pace to have, 303,000 houses sold, new homes sold this year. It's less than last year, okay? So the market is obviously in a depression. Actual health care premiums are actually going up. Now, according to the Kaiser Foundation, health care premiums increased by 9% in 2011 to 15,000, a little bit over 15,000, which is absolutely incredible. People are blaming Obamacare for this. They're saying that the companies are anticipating big increases because of the Obamacare. But at this point, Obamacare might not be around for much longer. A federal court recently ruled that Obamacare was unconstitutional. So instead of refiling there, the Obama administration decided to take it to the Supreme Court. Now, we may have a Supreme Court decision on Obamacare during an election year. So that'll be very, very interesting right there. Speaking of Obama, his support among blacks is weakening. The amount of blacks who rated him strongly favorable has decreased from the 80s to 58%. However, his overall support remains fairly high. Well, he's losing support among pretty much all the groups in general. Whites, Latinos, working class, middle class, whatever. It pretty much tells the story there. I strongly encourage people to check out a video called Ali on the First Black President. I think it says a lot. Well, a lot of black people say that Obama would have been better than McCain. Look, they pretty much represent the same neocon corporatist ideology. There was a difference, though. Well, let me put it to you this way: when a ship is going down, you don't want the puppet captain to look anything like you. Unfortunately, I think he was put in place by the elite to be used as a tool to racially divide people. And I think you're seeing signs of that already with a lot of the moves he's done. And I'm really sick of black celebrities and politicians going on TV talking about, you know, people who oppose Obama as racist and whatnot. You know, that's disrespectful to people who really are victims of racism, trying to marginalize the whole thing like that. It really pisses me off. Anyway, I came across a story of some prep kids being caught for stealing. Well, they weren't stealing. They were running a fraud. They were running a scheme, a testing scheme. One graduate who was really, really smart was taking tests for these kids. Okay, this is at some really elite public school, one of the wealthier areas. And I sort of chuckle at the whole story because they found out there was a big discrepancy between the grade point averages and the test scores for the SAT. Now, it seemed to me that the guy taking the test should have had enough sense to not score so high for kids who didn't have high grade point averages. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Anyway, the FBI's terrorist watch list. Did you know that people who have been cleared of crimes still end up on that list? Okay. yeah, that's the way it operates. 420,000 people, 420,000 names are on that list. Absolutely incredible. Many of them Americans. But, I mean, how many terrorists do they think are actually out there? I mean, either you have the evidence to prove that somebody is guilty or you don't. I don't like the idea of these watch lists. It doesn't sound very American. It doesn't seem like something you should have in a healthy, open society. You know, we're going to put you on our watch list. I mean, that's not something you would have in a healthy society at all. Anyway, as the elections approach, I want you to keep this in mind. Mitt Romney has so far raised twice as much money from Wall Street than Obama. And he's outraising Perry in that same crowd. Now, keep in mind, Goldman Sachs was pretty much Obama's first or second largest contributor in the 2008 election. And these same Wall Street firms play a big part. They're usually the biggest donors for Bush and McCain and these party leaders, these Republican Democratic nominees. So keep that in mind. I'm going to put a link at the bottom, and it shows that about 100 donors have already who supported Obama in 2008 are now supporting Romney. So maybe Romney really is winning this thing. Okay, this next story is really freaky, but I knew they were going to get around to doing it. Scientists have actually found a way to create an artificial womb. Okay, they're able to have an embryo outside of a woman's body and actually sustain it in an artificial womb. But, you know, it would be interesting if something like this was used by a military or by a government to create soldiers with really no parents, no family, and they just pretty much raise these kids or train these kids from the very beginning to be soldiers, to be killers. I know I'm moving into science fiction territory, but actually, the artificial wound, that's a reality now. It's incredible. It's a reality now. So I think it would be something that a military might try to do. They might try to genetically engineer babies to be stronger, to be better soldiers, and actually create them outside of a woman's body in an artificial wound. Sort of like the clones in Star Wars, in the latest Star Wars series. I mean, what do you guys think about this? I mean, is this an opportunity to help childless couples, or do you think this is going to be used by some weird science fiction military Frankenstein type of thing? I don't know, guys. You tell me. I think it will be eventually. But anyway, thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.